What is up, people? Back for another question and answer video. This is question and answer number 9. As usual, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that like button and leave a comment below, and I will talk to you guys later. Peace. What is up, people? Back for another question and answer video. Let's just have a round of applause for the fact that I actually remembered that I do this on this channel. Let's just take a moment to just clap. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Please, you're too kind. I literally took a month after usually saying that there would be a Q&A every week. 1 month later exactly, I begin to upload question and answer number 9. And I'm doing this on the fly too. I just played All For One. I feel disgusting because I really don't like that game mode. So I thought I would make myself feel a little bit better by answering some of your questions. So as usual, and I feel like saying this right now, it's the most important because I haven't uploaded this in so long. If you have missed past Q&A videos, there will be an annotation in the top left. So you guys can go click on that to see all the questions you may or may not have missed. This is obviously the series where I answer any question that you ask, within reason obviously, but I've answered some interesting questions, so I have nothing to hide. And it's just my way of kicking back and bonding with you lovely people. So as usual, at any point in this video, if you think of any questions that you do want answered, and trust me, I'll pretty much answer anything, make sure to leave it in the comment section below, and let's get into the first question. Question number 1 by the Endined Death Pro. If you could, and only if you could, would you motorboat Nidalee? You know what, as a matter of fact, hold on a second. Hey Nidalee, come here girl. Yeah, you know how it is. You know how it is. I hope that answers your question. Yeah, you know it's gonna be a good video when I start off like that. Question number 2 by Tiana Van Montfort. How was your youth? Was it rough, painful, or very happily? Honestly, every now and then, the talk about childhood comes up because I'm a little bit past childhood, I would say by now. And honestly, I always get into a conversation with somebody who just doesn't seem to appreciate their childhood. It's so weird because honestly, when I look back to when I was a kid, I would not change anything about it. I honestly love my childhood so much. I almost feel like I was super spoiled too. And I'm sure if I went up to anybody who knew me as a little kid, who was a little bit older than I was at the time, they would say I was spoiled too. I had all the clothes I ever needed. I grew up in a very nice place, had all my friends around me, went to a nice school, had every single video game I could ever want, every single toy. I got McDonald's like every Thursday. Like, I was a very happy kid. And of course, you know, the odd time I would do something bad and get punished. That's just the process of growing up. But every time I look back, honestly, and this is gonna sound super cheesy, get the tissues ready. I would honestly have to say that my parents did an awesome job raising me as a kid. So I really enjoyed my childhood. I wouldn't change anything about it. How was your guys' childhood? And childhood, I guess, ranges from, you know, 15 and below, I guess. If you're still a child, what's it like, bruh? Let me know, because honestly, I like seeing things from different perspectives. But as far as I'm concerned, and I've heard a lot of people say the opposite for some odd reason, like I grew up with them and they still don't seem happy. My childhood was pretty beastly. Question number 3 by Demo X Watcher. You said that you used to watch anime. What was your favorite show, and do you still watch / keep up with current ones? Unfortunately, I would have to say that my anime watching days are behind me. I used to watch a lot of anime though. And I think the first anime, ironically, that I watched was Sailor Moon. I could be wrong, but when I was 5 years old, the first type of animation that resembled anime in my memory was Sailor Moon. And that was before I went to kindergarten, so that was way back. But after that, I just kind of kept up with the typical Dragon Ball Z, Pokemon, Digimon. I can even name like weird ones. But for the most part, I've pretty much watched every notable anime, I would say. My favorites though, when I used to keep up with anime, was Ghost in the Shell, Claymore, Persona was a good one, Sword Art Online was a recent one that was really good. There was also this weird one that was all about 2012 and the end of the world that was also really good. Even a little bit of Yu-Gi-Oh! Like, you're lying if you grew up around that time and you're saying that you didn't have a deck and you didn't watch that show. And you're lying if you said that not once you tried to spike your hair like Yugi. Let's be real. But as far as recent anime goes, honestly, I don't know what's new. I don't know what's hot in anime land. Maybe one day when I have some time to just kick back, I'll watch new anime, but there hasn't been anything that really caught my eye lately. But if there is something I'm missing, like, you know, a sequel to something, I would really like to see more Persona, but I think that's wrapped up. Let me know in the comments section. Question number 3 by Wraith Plays. How do you stop people from blaming you for anything when it was actually them and they just needed someone to blame? game on LoL. Well, first of all, welcome to League of Legends. I don't think it's possible to go one day of League of Legends without actually encountering people like that. That's pretty much what the community is. Just a bunch of people that whenever they make a mistake, they just find someone else to blame. It's very rare that you actually see people say, shit, I shouldn't have done that, or that was completely my fault, or anything along those lines. Even I tend to blame other people a little bit when I play League of Legends. That's just the nature of the game. You know, it's a MOBA, it's competitive, and everybody wants to seem like a pro. What you can do is do one of these two things, and this is what I do personally. The minute someone reveals themselves as a resident of Tard City, hit the mute button. That's what it's there for. That's probably the most important button in the game. I would value the mute button more than the ability to move. It's just so important to not let yourself get distracted. So if that means you gotta mute your whole team, do it. And honestly, you would see that the game is 10 times more enjoyable when you do that anyway. And the second thing, which is something that I'm kind of famous for on my live streams, is reporting people in a very funny and creative way. So usually when I go through a game where people were tards and I just really want to take my anger out on them specifically, instead of just like typing in the chat and giving them a reason to report me, I report them creatively. And most of the time it looks like this. So there you go. You just gotta be one of those people with thick skin. You know, you gotta be prepared when you go into Summoner's Rift. Question number 5 by Purple Zombie Huntress. Any tattoos, bruh? I actually don't have any tattoos. I'm not yet in that stage to get tattoos. And I'm one of those people that believe that tattoos should only be on your body if they actually have a great deal of meaning. I see this mostly in girls, obviously, but I see a lot of girls get some dumb tattoos that they're gonna have to live with, and probably in a year or two they're gonna regret. And I feel like the only reason they get more after that is because they didn't quite like the first one as much as they thought they would. So I don't have any tattoos yet. I'm gonna wait for a moment in my life that is very, very important, and I will celebrate it with a tattoo. I will also get tattoos for some sad moments in my life when they come. That's how I'm feeling right now, but I do have piercings. Question number 6 by Cameron Anderson. What's the worst nightmare you've ever had? Well, fun fact about me, whenever I go to sleep, especially lately, I tend to have a nightmare. I really don't know why. It's kind of gotten to the point where nightmares are no longer scary. They're kind of interesting. So whenever I go to bed, I kind of ask myself what I'm gonna see tonight. It's kind of become one of those routines. But the one nightmare that kind of had the most effect on me and still kind of bothers me to this day is when I had a dream that the sun was gonna explode and there was no escape from it. Because one of the things that I definitely hate is dying from something that you can't escape. So when I hear that the sun's gonna explode in the morning, I'm not exactly happy. So that dream definitely messed me up. The sun did explode the very next day in that dream. I felt myself melt, and when I woke up, I couldn't open my eyes for 5 minutes because I actually thought they were melted shut. So welcome to the life of the legendary one himself. So let's share some dreams. I don't have a problem sharing dreams, honestly. So if you guys want to leave some nightmares you've had in the comments section, I will respond to them. I will share one of my many nightmares. I'll probably have one tonight, so I will have a fresh one for tomorrow. And we'll just feel bad for ourselves together. Question number 7 by Brandon Jens. What inspires you to start YouTube? Honestly, this is something that pops into my head every couple months. I would honestly hope if you're on YouTube doing it for a while, that you kind of reflect on your journey once in a while. And that's something that I usually do. And the one question that always pops up is, why did you start doing this, bruh? Because honestly, I don't know. By the way, I'm ahead of the times. Like, I've been recording myself since I was like 9 years old. Maybe not with a microphone, but I always got a kick out of recording myself playing games on like a VCR. I used to put a tape in and I used to record myself playing my Nintendo 64. At the time, it was either Smash Brothers or Ocarina of Time. I really don't know what it was, but I honestly just got a kick out of watching myself do something that I already did. recorded on video. So I've been doing this before everybody. I'm actually the true pioneer of this YouTube gaming thing. And honestly, it would be nice to show those videos. I think I still have them too on VHS, but I have no idea how I'm gonna get a VHS video onto my computer. But aside from that, I just went on YouTube one day, saw that a bunch of people were doing this, and you know, I had the usual thought that everybody kind of has, which is I can do this too. But I think mine was a little more serious, because I see a lot of people start this and then fall off in like a couple weeks or a month because they realize it actually takes work and time and money. But yeah, this was just something that I felt like I needed to be a part of, because what it is at the end of the day is a community, and what's a gaming community without the legendary one himself? Question number 8 by Anton DiDonato. I probably butchered that so hard. Apologies in advance, but that's just what I do on these videos. What's your opinion on the 3.14 patch? I only have two negative things to say. The first one is, how dare you nerf the wife? Okay, the Nidalee nerf is weird. It's not negative by any means. I feel like that should have been done a long time ago, because how many of us have been rickrolled by Nidalee on Howling Abyss? So the changes to her spear are kind of weird to get used to, you know? That's just what it is, really. But other than that, I really don't have a problem with the Nidalee adjustments. And the second thing is, honestly, I feel like my masteries just aren't up to par. I've set them up in a very different way compared to how I did in Season 3. And although I'm getting the right stats, it seems, it always seems like you have a little more AD than what you actually want, no matter what you pick. So other than that, I guess I could say that I don't like trinkets, but I'm learning to adapt to it. I just feel like trinkets is something that they put in the game to force people to work together. It's pretty much for lazy people who never warded in the past. That's what I feel like a trinket is now. But other than that, honestly, 3.14 is really nice. I like the health bars. I like the new jungle. It just feels like a better game. I have played League more in the past 2 days than I have in the past month. Question number 9 by Michael. Do you ever want to have kids in the future? I don't think about this often, but whenever I do, it's a definite hell no. Because on one hand, I've seen some kids that honestly make me never want to have kids ever. It actually makes me surprised that I was once like that. I've even complained about kids recently. Kids just have this weird ability to get under your skin, and then whenever I talk to someone who saw me as a kid, they're like, oh, you were the same way, you were annoying just like them, blah blah blah. So I don't really know about having kids in the future. Honestly though, down the road, when I've figured out everything that I need to figure out and I find the Nidalee that I need, then yeah, why not? Maybe. And question number 10 by Jonathan Alvarez. Most embarrassing moment of your school life? Now, honestly, I can't believe I'm about to tell this story. I've only told one other person this story. Because I'm about to tell you this story, please do me the honor of hitting this like button. Show me that you appreciate this moment that honestly I will forever have on video to embarrass myself with. I'm taking one for the team, and I'm gonna share an embarrassing life story. There's not many, there's probably about 3. I've had a pretty normal slash exciting life. But this was a negative moment. When I was in like grade 4, before going to school, I used to eat these Fred Flintstone like vitamin things that kids eat. I'm pretty sure you've seen them before. The problem is, they were usually on the table for me to eat, because if they just let me go into it, I would eat like 50 of them because they tasted so good. So there was 2 Fred Flintstone vitamins and something else that looked similar, but it wasn't exact, but it was similar. And because I was a dumbass like kid in grade 4, I pretty much thought that that was like a faulty vitamin, like I'm gonna eat it anyway type of thing. It's kind of like when you're eating chips and then you see that brown chip and you're like, screw it, I'm gonna eat the chip anyway. That's kind of what I did. The sad thing about that faulty vitamin, in quotes, was that it wasn't a Fred Flintstone vitamin, but it was one of those pills that you take when you need to clean out your stomach, if you catch my drift. So I go to school after consuming all 3, and around recess time, I really had to go. So you can see where this story is going already. Problem is, there was a lineup for the line and I didn't get to go because the lunch lady was a D-bag. So I'm sitting there in class, I really gotta go. Finally, the teacher's like, okay, I think this is serious, you can go to the bathroom. I spend a good while in that bathroom and come back because I figure, you know what, I'm all right. I feel good, I feel normal. But that's just toilet trolls, because every time that happens, you quickly have to go back again because it's just one of those pills, you know, that that pill was made by a troll. I sit down. I ask to go to the washroom again. I have this look on my face like I just saw a Mewtwo in the grass. And my teacher's looking at me like, come on now, bruh. Are you for realsies? And I'm like, yeah. So I go back to the bathroom and I come back. And then a third time comes by about an hour later and I gotta go. And he's like, maybe you should just go and skip this class. Like, he's telling a grade 4 to skip this class. He understands the struggle. He understands where I'm coming from. But unfortunately, I could not hold this one in. And, you know, the story kind of explains itself. So I'm sitting there. Luckily, I was, you know, wearing certain underwear that kind of kept it all in. But I had a problem that I had to tend to. So instead of going back to the bathroom, I go to the office and I'm like, I kind of got to go home. And the secretary is like, why? And I just kind of explained that I've had an accident. You know, I was very professional for my age and that I need to go. So she's like, okay, sit down right there and we'll call your parents to come pick you up. Very understanding school, by the way. Now that I think about it, that secretary was a boss. But then I ask her if I could go to the washroom because it's starting to get uncomfortable and I gotta go again. I get up and my boxers kind of let out everything that I was holding in. And it's kind of funny because even though this is a bad moment, it's kind of funny because the janitor was ironically standing right there. And when he looked at the floor beneath me, he had this expression on his face like the world just ended, like he was having a perfect day. He pretty much just won the lottery. He met this girl, like he got a good lunch. He was having the perfect day. And then his face, his whole aura just changed when he saw what I did. Not to mention there was like a bunch of people around me that actually saw it too. So after that embarrassing moment, I got to go home. And funny enough, as soon as I get home, I feel better. Yeah. So if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and leave a comment below. If you have any questions that you want answered in the next Q&A video, whenever that will be, probably next year, make sure to leave it in the comment section below, and I will talk to you guys later. Peace. Now put your hands up. Now put your hands up. Now put your